Example number 1. The question is, if 15 dates are selected at random, what is the probability of getting 2 Sundays? So 15 dates in the sense, you are going to select randomly. So we do not know whether it contains 2 Sundays or not. So here we have to take the probability value of your success and then about the number of trials. Here the number of trials is n is equal to 15. So they have given the number of trials and you know the probability value. So how many Sundays are there in a week? It is only 1. So if you have to select that one day, the probability value will be 1/7. So 1 is the favorable event, that is for getting Sunday, and 7 given here is a sample space. We have 7 days in a week. So it is clearly given that it is determined on 2 things. The first one is number of trials, which is equal to 15 here, and the second one is probability value, which is equal to 1/7. Okay, now we have 2 values, but for defining a function we need another one value, which is the Q value, failure value, and Q is equal to 1 - p. So 1 - p in the sense 1 - 1/7, which is equal to 6/7. Now we have found all the values, that is n, p and q. Now we have to substitute this in the formula so that we will calculate the probability value. We will see the rest of this problem in the next slide. Example number 1, continuation. Now we have found the values for n, p and q. Now what we have to find is that we have to find the probability mass function. Probability mass function in a binomial distribution, f of x is equal to ncx p power x into q power n minus x. So here f of x is equal to 15cx 1/7 power x into 6/7 power 15 minus x. I have substituted the value for n as 15, p as 1/7 and q as 6/7. So now after substituting this value, if you see the first term, that is 15cx, it is clear that the x value should lie within 15. So here the x value will be 0, 1, 2 till 15 values. So now what is the probability we have to find is that for getting 2 Sundays. So here the x value will be equal to 2. Now substituting x as 2, we will get an equation that f of 2 is equal to 15c2 1/7 the whole square into 6/7 power 15 minus 2. So the next value we get is 105 into 6 power 13 divided by 7 power 15, which you, if you multiply the terms, will get the value as 0.29. So hence the probability of getting 2 Sundays in selecting 15 days at random will be equal to 0.29. Example number 2. The question is, the incidence of occupational disease in an industry is such that the workmen have 10% chance of suffering from it. What is the probability that out of 5 workmen, 3 or more will contract the disease? Now the solution for this problem, you have to take x is equal to number of workmen in the sample, and then now n is equal to 5. 5 in the sense we are going to calculate the probability out of 5 only. So here the n value is equal to 5, and then about the probability value of success is 10% given here. So we will convert the percentage into a decimal value. So 10/100 will give you 0.1. That is your probability of success, which is equal to p here. And then for calculating q value, q is always equal to 1 - p. So 1 - 0.1 is equal to 0.9. So here we have found the n value, p value and q value. Now we have to find the function and then we have to move on to the problem. Here the question is asked to find the probability that out of 5, 3 or more men will contract the disease. So with this probability case, we have to substitute the x value in the function and then we have to find the answer for this problem. We'll see the rest of this problem in the next slide. Example number 2, continuation. So we have found the values for n, p and q. Now we have to write the probability mass function, which is f of x is equal to n c x p power x into q power n minus x. So substituting the values for n, p and q, we'll get an equation 5 c x into 0.1 power x into 0.9 power 5 minus x. So substituting the values, we'll definitely know the value for x, which can be in 0, 1, 2 till 5 values. So we have found the value for x also. Now coming to the question, they have asked to find the probability that 3 or more workmen will contract the disease. So 3 or more, in the sense it is greater than or equal to 3. Now p of x value will be taken as p of x greater than or equal to 3. So greater than or equal to in the 3 is, we have to substitute the values for x. Now here we know that the value for x lies between 0 till 5. So taking the values which are greater than or equal to 3, we'll get 3 values, 3, 4 and 5. So we have to substitute the values of 3, 4 and 5 in the distribution equation. So we will get f of 3 plus f of 4 plus f of 5. On substituting the values in the function, we will get 5c3, 0.1 power 3, 0.9 power 5 minus 3 plus 5c4, 0.1 power 4, 0.9 power 5 minus 4 plus 5c5, 0.1 power 5 and 0.9 power 5 minus 5, which you will get a value of power 0. So the value will be equal to 1. So we haven't mentioned it here. And the next step is, we have to convert the powers into values. So converting the values, we will get 10 into 0.001 into 0.81 plus 5 into 0.0001 into 0.9 plus 1 into 0.00001. And the next step, we have to multiply these values and write it as 0.0086. So we will get an answer for the problem, which is the probability value that 3 or more men will be suffering from that disease. So this is the answer for this problem. Example number 3. The question given is, find the binomial distribution for which mean and standard deviation are 6 and 2 respectively. Now binomial distribution, in this sense, we have to find the distribution value, that is f of x. So we need not substitute the values for x, just we have to find the distribution alone. So the solution for this problem, we all know that x, that is binomial distribution, depends only on the values of n and p. Here they have given the mean value and the standard deviation value. So mean value, that is nothing but the value for n into p, which is equal to 6, and then the standard deviation of x is equal to 6. So standard deviation, in the sense, it is root of n p q, which is equal to 2 here. So variance is nothing but the square of the standard deviation. So variance of x, which is n p q, will be equal to 2 square, which is again equal to 4. So here the variance value is equal to 4 and the mean value is equal to 6. Now we have to find the value for q and p, because we have to substitute this in our equation. Now we know that dividing 2 and 1, that is the dividing npq divided by np, will get the value for q. So with that value, we can find the value for p also and n also. So first, finding the value for q, we will get q is equal to 2 divided by 3. And then the value for p will be equal to 1 minus Q. 1 is the total probability minus a failure value gives a value of success, which is equal to 1 minus 2 by 3. So, you will get the value for P is equal to 1 by 3. Now, we have found the value for Q and P. Now, again we have to find the value for N, after which we have to substitute it in the equation of F of X. So, we will solve this in the next slide. Example number 3, continuation. So, we have found the values for P and Q. Now, we have to find the value for N and substitute in the equation of F of X. So, for finding the value for N, we have to substitute in the equation of mean, which is equal to NP. So, we know the value for mean and also we know the value for P. So, if you substitute these values, we will get the value for N. So, substituting P is equal to 1 by 3 in the equation, we will get N into 1 by 3 is equal to 6 and N will be equal to 18. So, now we have found the value for N also. The last thing we have to do is that we have to find the probability mass function of X, which is given by F of X is equal to NCX into P power X into Q power N minus X. So, substituting the known values, we will get an equation 18CX into 1 by 3 power X into 2 by 3 power 18 minus X. So, here 18CX, with that we can tell the values for X, which starts from 0, 1, 2 till 18. So, we have also found the value in which the X lies and the distribution function also. So, this is the answer for this problem.